All right, now I'm going to just show you how to make a jigsaw puzzle. To make a jigsaw puzzle, you're going to go to a site called Jiggity. And it just looks like this, jiggity.com. I already have an account, so it's signed in as me. But if you have not created an account, go ahead and create an account. Do not tell your students to create an account. They do need to be a certain age to do this. So let's say, for example, one of my clues was like my favorite animal, and you want them to figure out what your favorite animal is. You can pick something and they can just, I don't know, choose one of these images. You can also choose to create your own. So if I want to, I can do this puzzle. But I'm going to show you how to create your own today. So I am going to insert an image that I already have pulled up. You can also choose an image from your computer. It just has to be a certain size. If it's not a certain size, it's not going to work. So let's just drag this sushi clue to, oh, no. Let's choose an image, and we're going to type in sushi clue. I'm going to go open. This is what my puzzle will look like. I can change the sizes of the puzzle pieces. Don't go past, I would say, 30, 40. That's what Kylene recommended, and I would say that's pretty decent, maybe 24 pieces. Now, when you click on create, if you just give them this, then they know what it's supposed to look like, and then they can solve the puzzle. You don't want that. So click on solve puzzle, and then what ends up happening is you have all of these pieces, and they have to unscramble it. My clue is going to be like, my favorite food is the middle pair of the puzzle. So the top middle row pair in the puzzle, and it's a little sushi with soy sauce. So that would be my clue. It would be like, my favorite food is sushi. And I've done this before with my students. They really love it. But in order to do this, you need to copy this clue so you can control C it. And then remember on your Google form how you had your different clues that you were going in. Mine's all done, but if I was going to change this up and I wanted to like edit this, I could say instead my favorite food, I could make a hyperlink, and then I would just post in the hyperlink. So if I highlighted this word, for example, I would click on hyperlink, and then I would paste in that sushi clue. I do not want to do that because I already have my Google thing all finished for the day. My Google site is completely done. That's a good way to add a puzzle into the escape room. And then when the students go in to do this, I'll just show you what they would see. They literally see the puzzle all mixed up. So they don't get your answer. So they'll be brought to this specific sushi clue page. And it's just a really fun thing for them to do. You can also post a puzzle in your Google Classroom in the morning for them to solve. It's just really fun. So have fun with that. Until next time. Bye.